Okay, so this is going to be a brand new playthrough of Pokemon FireRed. I am sure that most people are already familiar with this game by now, but this kind of video is new to me, so I look forward to doing it. I probably won't be doing any of the voices or anything on the characters speaking, but you may have already figured that out by now. Okay, so here I'm going to go with a boy, obviously, and I'm going to go with my surname, which is Hunter. I usually go with my first name, but I feel like doing something different for the emulation. For my rival's name, I think I'm just going to keep it simple as well and go with Gary. Apologies if there's any buzzing in the background or if it's really quiet. I'm having trouble with my mic at the moment. I don't quite know how to sort it out. So any advice on that or any help on that would be great as well. This is all recorded on an emulator, a popular emulator, Visual Boy Advanced. So if any of you know how to make it run more smoothly and how to fix the audio on it and everything, then just pop it down in the comments section and that would be greatly appreciated. Just take out this free potion here that not many people know about, but every time you start one of the older games there's usually a potion in your PC, so that could come in handy, especially if your first battle you usually need it then. Just going to quickly personalise the frames and the text speed here to speed things up a bit, just to get that personal feel to it. And come with a red frame to suit the game. Sorry if you guys are finding it hard to understand me as well. I have got a very thick Birmingham accent. I'm originally from England and I have got a bit of a cold at the moment, so hopefully that gets better in the future. Okay then, so this is it. Time to pick our very first Pokemon of the series. Okay, I've already decided to go with Charmander, as I usually start with a fire type in most games, and I feel it suits the game FireRed a lot better than the other two. Also, it's a pretty popular choice as well. I mean, it's usually a Charmander or a Squirtle anyway. I never seem to usually bother with nicknames. I tend not to like them, to be honest. But if anyone wants a Pokemon that I've caught to have a certain nickname, then just leave it in the comments section, and perhaps maybe I might change it when I get to Lavender Town. If anyone's got any like tips or things I might have missed in the game so far or during the course of this series, then feel free to shout them out. And if anyone needs any help with anything, then don't be afraid to ask. Feel free to leave them in the comment section and I'll get back to you as soon as possible. Well, it's a good job I got that potion after all, and looks like it's going to come in real use here. It's very handy to have. So just like that, large thanks to the potion, we win our first battle against our rival. Always a good thing. Here we go then, off to leave Pallet Town for the very first time, Pokemon in hand in the tall grass, making our first steps along Route 1, and we encounter our first wild Pokemon, which happens to be a female Rattata. I'll hopefully sweep this aside fairly quickly. Once again, sorry if the text is moving too quickly for everyone, running it as fast as I can go, because I am a fairly quick reader. I am trying to slow it down to a decent amount of time though, so everybody can read what's on screen. So as we take on another Rattata here, I just wanted to take the time to say that I already know what I want my ideal team to be, as some of them are my favourite Pokemon from this generation. But if any of you guys have got any requests or think I should be using other Pokemon, better Pokemon perhaps, then feel free to leave them in the comment section and they will be taken into consideration. Dealing with another Rattata, I've managed to beat that one as well, surprisingly, and about to make our first steps into Viridian City here. I was thinking about starting a Nuzlocke challenge because I've never actually done one of those before, because I don't really know many good ones, but if you guys know of any ones that make it more fun to play, then just leave it below and I'll have a look into it. I'm sure most of us already know about the types and the effects and everything all like that. We're all very up on our Pokemon knowledge and everything, but in case you're not, then just ask. And also, not very many people do know this one, but if you check the bookcase here, you can find a journal, and these journals, they'll tell you about people like Professor Oak, which you can then look up on your fame checker. You can play the fame checker, which I didn't know about for a long time myself, but that's also something to complete within the game. Okay, so I think that's all for this week. I think I'm going to leave it here, to be honest. Save up. This is going to be a weekly episodic series, and as always, any questions or requests will be welcomed. So if I missed anything, just don't hesitate, just ask away. I do play and own copies of the original Pokemon games on DS and 3DS, and I will leave my friend code in the description for anyone that wants to add it. So I look forward to seeing you all next week, and I hope you've had fun watching this video, and any input would be much appreciated. So goodbye for now. and always remember to take care.